His own recent times when issues of sustainability have been regularly coming up, that there is a relationship. There is now an attempt to look at agriculture also as an ecological system. Here comes up the ideas of sustainable agriculture. And what is sustainable agriculture? Sustainable agriculture is the practice of farming using principles of ecology, that is the study of relationships between organisms and their environment. Responsible agriculture enables us to produce more healthy foods that, without compromising the future generation's ability to do the same. And the main objectives of this sustainable agriculture includes to make most efficient use of non-renewable resources and on-farm resources and integrate part where it is appropriate, and to sustain the economic viability of farm operations and enhance the quality of life of farmers and society as a whole. And sustainable agriculture practices are intended to protect the environment, expanding the Earth's natural resource base and maintain and improve the soil fertility. Based on a multiple prong goal, sustainable agriculture seeks to increase the profitable farm income and as well as to promote environmental stewardship. And the benefits of sustainable agriculture includes environmental preservation, upholding welfare, animal welfare, and protection of public health and sustaining vibrant community. Please, the
previous is so this will take you to previous, this is the next one, and this is the pointer.
Yeah, environmental preservation. How is it beneficial to environmental preservation? Sustainable farming produces crops and raise animals without relying on toxic chemicals, pesticides, synthetic fertilizers, genetically modified seeds, or practices that degrade soil, water, or any other natural resources. Thus, sustainable agriculture gives benefits to environmental preservation. And upholding animal welfare. Sustainable farmers and ranchers treat animals with care and respect, implementing livestock husbandry practices that protect animals' health and ability. And protection of public health. Since sustainable crop farms avoid hazardous chemicals, pesticides, they are able to grow fruits and vegetables that are more safer for consumers. And sustaining vibrant communities. Sustainable agriculture has its own ability to remain economically viable, providing farmers and others that are employed in this food system with a livable wage and safe fair working connection. And the techniques of sustainable farming includes integrated pest management. This integrated pest management, also known as integrated pest control, is a broad-based approach that integrates the practices of economic control of pests, and it also aims to suppress pest populations below the economic injury level. And crop rotation. Crop rotation is the practice of farming or growing a series of similar or different types of crops in the same area in sequence seasons. It is done so that soil of the farms are not used for only one set of nutrients, and it also helps in soil erosion. It also decreases soil erosion and increases soil fertility and crop yield, and also mitigates the buildup of pathogens and pests. And biotechnology. Agriculture biotechnology, also known as agri-tech. It is an agricultural science involving the use of scientific tools and techniques, including crop modifying, genetic engineering, molecular diagnostics, and tissue culture and molecular markers to modify living organisms, their plants, animals, and approved biotechnology is one of the aspect, aspect of agricultural biotechnology which is really been developed in recent times. And organic farming. Organic farming is a method of producing crops and raising livestock that that are mainly focused on use of organic fertilizers, organic waste that are derived from organic that are derived from animals waste and vegetables waste. And then conservation tillage. Conservation tillage is an agricultural management approach that aims to minimize frequency or intensity of tillage operations in an effort to promote certain economic and environmental benefits. So the it also includes decreasing carbon dioxide and greenhouse gas emissions. And the remaining steps will be given by the
I will be presenting the rest of the slides. And this, what I've given here is that all the factors that makes agriculture sustainable. There are, first of all, we need a healthy soil. The foundation of sustainable agriculture is a healthy soil. Because without healthy soil, we cannot plant vegetation. So we will not be, we will be using only organic fertilizer, not pesticides, not synthetic fertilizer. So we need a healthy soil to begin with. And there, to make sustainable, our efforts should have conservation of water. And we can do this by using drip irrigation. Drip irrigation means we use water judiciously to provide each irrigation plant with minimal water, optimal water in its portion of water. We should have responsible waste management system because if we get much waste, then it's no longer sustainable agriculture. So we need a small number of animals to be raised in an integrated farm. Integrated farm means the waste product from other animals are used for feeding of other vegetation or for the food of other animals. And animal waste provide nutrients like what I've discussed before. The animal waste provides nutrients to growing crops without polluting water cells into water bodies and rotational grazing by cow cattle because they have different activity because they have different grazing patterns. And adaptive crops. The adaptive crops are crops which are locally grown and adapted to the local conditions. And the farmer raised animals and plants adapted to the existing environment. Ecological pest management. The aim of this method is to manage pests within the minimal environmental effect and by using natural predators, beneficial microorganisms, elimination of breeding grounds, poison pests, and traps. And because although these are practiced, but non-target pests are often killed and too often the beneficial predators. So the health consequences of not using ecological pest management may include pesticide poisoning. And energy conservation. Well, if the field is small, we should use small equipment, not use large equipment because energy is conserved in sustainable agriculture. And we can use power stations also. So with agriculture, if we practice agriculture, there should be some profit. If there's no profit, there's no use of there is no use of practicing an activity without any profitability. So we just so we should increase profitability and reduce risk and consumers. We should keep healthy for consumers and the risk of farmers should also be well understood. And here is a case study of Manipur and sustainable agriculture. The hilly regions of Manipur it covers 90% of the total land area of the state and the most widely practiced cultivation in the hills is the zone cultivation and this is not yet sustainable but in hills there is another method called terrace farming and it is a sustainable agricultural method practiced in the hills of Manipur because they can introduce again. And its importance the importance of terrace farming may include decrease in water soil erosion and surface runoff of water because they use walls made of plants and maybe used to support growing crops and river irrigation systems. And the plains of Manipur and 9% of the total land area belongs to the central Central Valley and one parcel of the Tell and area constitute the Jaywa plan, and main cultivated crops are paddy, mustard, and cabbage, maize, polyporpies, etc. And sustainable agricultural practices in Manipur includes crop rotation, mixed farming, organic farming, etc. Some of the organizations are here which also help in improvement of sustainable agriculture in Manipur. They are MSFAC, which is as Manipur Small Farmers Agri Business Consortium, KVK Toba, Krishi Vigyan Kendra Toba, AFTMA Manipur, Agricultural Technology and Technology Management Agency Manipur. And this is a brief collection of data of the World 17 where this is the in sustainable agriculture, the Zoom cultivation is not suggested, but in Manipur, the Zoom cultivation is still done in the hilly parts of the region. And in Zoom cultivation, the area practiced in the, this is a four very district of Manipur, and in this four very district, the Zoom cultivation is not practiced, but in the hilly regions of Manipur, the Zoom cultivation is practiced. And out of the area of 7.9 thousand hectare, in Ubud, 7.9 hectares is the Zoom cultivation is practiced for about 7.9 thousand hectares in Ubud in Chandpur. The number of listed is as follows, and this is the production. Out of 7.97 areas practiced, the total yield is 7.65 production. And here, the challenges faced by practicing sustainable agriculture is that in sustainable agriculture we have to not use the synthetic fertilizers, pesticides, and all. So organic farming is suggested, but organic farming, the growth of organic farming is very slow in India because the effect is even more security. We need food security as our first goal. So, it's never been on the spot. It's in the last year. And the farmers have retained the traditional practices and using manpower in small farm resulted in lesser enthusiasm to sustainable agriculture. Conclusion. The challenges for future in the areas of sustainable agriculture are economical, scientific, socio-economical, media, and political, including public awareness among the people, farmers, teachers, and students, and also participatory research as well as social and political
management. Okay. Any questions? Any questions? Okay. So I have a few questions and some comments. So first of all, being the same thing, references. You have to inculcate the habit of your own. Otherwise, it's a monkey. You don't want to. Okay? Of course, you're young, you're starting career, so then, too many lines. Your slides, you know, you've got more than four or three or four lines. It's very hard for us to read. That's not the kind of thing. I mean, sometimes it's inevitable, but I understand. You know. And then, first part of the presentation is all about definitions. We don't need those definitions. Just get into, it's good that you know you gave a good case study, which is really nice. And see, because the lack of time, you're presenting too much of definition data for the data discussions that you have. That is one thing. And I think I like the data that you presented, where you have different regions. I think you dug a little deep and then you were able to go over. It's really nice. And the solutions that you're proposing also is practical. I think many of the solutions are already being used, right? That's the idea. Okay? So we should propose to which is really good, I thought. Overall, that's what I thought was really good. Any last questions, please, group is? No? Okay, thank you.